Hello students, today we are going to learn how to draw bar graphs. Okay, a bar graph generally looks like this, where there are two axes. X axis is horizontal and y axis is the vertical. Their point of intersection is origin, that is zero. Then on the x axis we write the names of the things about which the graph is showing the information. And on the y-axis, we write the numbers that are related to this information. So, before drawing a graph, we also need to select the scale on the y-axis, that how many units we will take for drawing the bars. So, let's take one example. Information about the plants in a nursery is given here. Show it in a bar graph. So here some information about the plants is given in a nursery. So name of plants are given and the number of plants in that nursery is given. 70 mogra, 50 zai, hibiscus 45 and chrysanthemum 80. This information we want to show on a graph paper. So in the previous lecture we have seen what is a graph paper. It has some dark lines and this gap is divided into equal number of 10 parts with faint lines. So first step is write the name of the graph in the center. So what is this graph about? Type and number of plants. Type of plants and number of plants. Always use pencil for drawing a graph. Now the next step is in the bottom of the page. Leave two boxes and draw the x-axis. Draw the x-axis on the dark green line. You have to draw it on a dark green line. Remember that axis is a line, so give arrows and write the name. This is x axis. Now again, leave two blocks and on this dark green line, draw the y axis. Vertical axis is the y axis. Remember that it should exactly be on the dark line. Little bit also you cannot move it here and there. Exactly it should be on the dark green line. This is a line, so give arrows. We can extend it according to our requirement. Now let's decide the scale first. If you observe all these numbers they are divisible by 5, means all these number they are present in the table of 5, means they are the factors of 5. So we will take the scale as, first write down the scale on y axis, where we represent the numbers are shown on y axis. This is the y axis, write down here y. And this point of intersection is O. Mark it as O. Then this you have to write compulsory. Scale on y-axis. One unit is equal to 5 plants. One unit is 5 plants. One unit means how much? The distance between two dark lines. So let's begin. First will be 5. After 0, first dark line will be 5. Then 10. Then this is 15. This is 20. 25. 30. 35. 40, 45, 50, 55 60 65 70 75 and 80, because the highest number in that table is 80. So like this we will write the numbers till 80. Remember that in the question there are the numbers 45 50 70 and 80. So don't do like this, that whichever numbers are given in the question that only we have to write here. No, whatever scale we have selected, scale we have selected as 5, one unit is 5. So you have to write the complete table of 5 till the highest number that we want. Okay, so if we want 45, then don't skip these numbers. 45 जो पहला नंबर हमें चाहिए सबसे छोटा, तो सिर्फ 45 शो करेंगे, बाकी के नंबर्स दिखाएंगे ही नहीं, ऐसा नहीं है. यू हैव टू मार्क टिल 45 ऑल द नंबर्स, बिकॉज व्हेन यू विल लीव दीज मेनी यूनिट्स देन यू विल गेट 45. नाइन्थ लाइन विल बी 45. सो 5 5 5 5, सो लाइक दिस इफ यू काउंट देन ओनली यू विल गेट 45. नाउ ऑन द एक्स एक्सिस we have to write the names of the plants. Names of plants. First plant is Mogra. Now, how many Mogra plants are there? 70. So, from 0, we will draw a bar till 70. On the dark green lines. And join these two with scale and pencil. Here we have left one unit of space. After every plant we will leave one unit of space. Remember that this space should be equal in distance for all the bars. Now the second one is Jai, 50 plants. So leave one box, then write down here Jai. How many? 50. So from 0, we will draw a bar till 50. Then again, leave one box. And then hibiscus is there. Hibiscus. Whatever name is there, write in that gap only. Okay, don't write it bigger. How many hibiscus plants are there? 45. So after this bar, leave one box and take 45. So 45 plants of hibiscus. See here, it is 45, means this dark line, join it. Next is chrysanthemum. Eighty plants, so leave one box and then draw a bar till 80. So this is chrysanthemum. Now the next is we have to shade the bars. We have to shade the bars. So if it is not possible to shade it, then just draw small small lines with scale and pencil. Like this you can shade, or you can shade it completely with pencil. Choice is yours, whichever you find easy. But remember that you have to choose any one method for all the graphs. same method for all the bars. Means if you are shading like this, then all bars you have to shade the same way in that answer. Or if you are shading like this, then all the bars should be shaded like this only. So in this way we have completed. And what is this on y-axis? These are number of plants. So here we will write number of plants, and on the x-axis name of plants, and here number of plants. So like this you have to draw the bar graph. Now in this example we can take one more scale also, means we can take one unit equal to 10 plants. So you will get a graph like this, 1 centimeter. This gap is 1 centimeter. So this you can take 10 plants also. Then what you will do, you will write the table of 10 here, 10 20 30 40 50 60 70 80. Now for Mogra it is 70, Zai it is 50, Chrysanthemum it is 80, but Hibiscus is 45. So 40 to 50 there are 10 units, means half of 40 and 50 will be 45. So here we will draw the line of 45. After 40, fifth line will be 45. So like this also you can draw the same graph. Now let's begin with practice set 19. So what we have learned till now? Every bar in the graph should be of equal width. Okay. The distance between any two adjacent bars should be equal, and all bars should be of appropriate height. So the width should be same for all the bars. So here we have taken one box. So leave one box. This gap is also important. Leave here one box, here also and here also. Then whatever width is there, means you cannot do like this, that this bar you have drawn this much and the next bar you will draw this much only. So it is not possible. Ek bar chota aur ek bar width mein bada. Width means like this. Ek bada, ek chota, aise nahi chalega. Width of all the bars should be same. This gap should be also same. Now another example we will take. The names of the head of families in a village and quantity of drinking water their family consumes in one day are given below. Draw a bar graph for this data. And remember that scale is also given in the question only. If scale is given in the question, then it is compulsory to use the same scale. And if it is not given in the question, then we can select the scale of our choice. So here, name of the head of family is given. Ramesh, Shobha, Ayub, Julie and Rahul. And the water, drinking water that is used by their family in one day is given. Ramesh's family uses 30 liter drinking water in one day. Shobha's family 60 liter. Ayub 40, Julie 50 and Rahul 55. So this information we need to show on the graph paper. So let's begin. First step is give heading to a graph. So here we can give heading that head of family and water used in one day. Water used in one day. So this information we have to show on the graph paper. So what is the first step? Draw the x-axis. X-axis means horizontal. So leave two box from the bottom and draw the x-axis on the dark green line. Compulsory on the dark green line. Give arrows. Immediately write down here x-axis. Then draw the y-axis. Leave two box. And on the dark line, draw the y-axis. Give arrows. and write here y axis. Then this point of intersection is 0. Then next step is write the scale first. Scale is very essential. Scale, what is the scale? On y axis 1 centimeter equal to 10 liters. 1 centimeter means what? This one box is of 1 centimeter. This distance from here till here, it is 1 centimeter. So we can call it 1 unit also or 1 centimeter also. Now we have taken the scale of 10 liter. So mark the points 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 and 70. We will stop till 70 because highest number in the question is 60. So till 70 it is sufficient. Now on the x-axis, what we are going to take? Name of head of family. Head of family ka naam hum lenge x-axis pe. And on y-axis, what we are taking? Water used in liters. What is the unit of measuring this water? This water is measured in the liters. So water used in liters. Now Ramesh's family requires 30 liter. So first leave one box and write down here Ramesh. How much water he requires? 30 liter. So draw a rectangular bar till 30 like this. Then next is Shobha. So leave one box and then take Shobha 60 liter. Shobha's family requires 60 liter. So draw a bar. Next is Ayub. Ayub's family requires 40 liters. So leave one box and draw a bar of 40 liters. Then Julie. So leave one box. Then Julie's family requires 50 liters. Till 50 you have to draw the bar. And last is Rahul. Rahul's family requires 55 liters. So 55 number is not here. But between 50 and 60, there are 10 numbers. So first line will be 51, second line 52, third 53, fourth 54, and fifth line will be 55. Little bit dark line is given between two dark lines. So choose that line exactly. This is the line of 55. Between 50 and 60. 55 will be between 50 and 60. Fifth line. Now after drawing these rectangular bars, we have to shade the bars in the same pattern by using pencil. Strictly you have to use only pencil on the graph paper. Never use pen. So in this way you have to shade all the bars. Like this the graph will look. Now the next example is names and number of animals in a certain zoo are given below. Use the data to make a bar graph and scale is given on y-axis 1 centimeter equal to 4 animals. So in that zoo, deer are 20, tiger 4, monkey 12, rabbit 16 and peacock are 8. And what is the scale? On y-axis 1 centimeter equal to 4 animals. So first step is draw x-axis, then draw y-axis. Here name of animals and number of animals. Now scale is 4. So we will write the table of 4, complete table of 4 till 24 we have written. Because highest number is 20. So jitna highest number hai usse ek zyada likh ke chhod dena hai. So 4, 2 1s are 4, 2s are 8, 3s are 12, 4s are 16, 5s are 20, 6s are 24. Then write down here name. Deer how much? 20. So draw the bar till 20. Then tiger 4. Then monkey 12. Rabbit 16. And peacock 8. Like this you have to draw. Now the next example is. Table below gives the number of children who took part in the various items of the talent show as a part of annual school gathering. Make a bar graph to show this data. So, in the program, theater, 24 students took part, dance, 40 students, vocal music, 16, instrumental music, 8 students, and one act play, 4 students. It should be actually play. What is the scale given? On y-axis, 1 centimeter you have to take 4 children. So again the same process. First draw the x-axis, then draw the y-axis. Write here 0. Here various items of the talent and here number of children. Scale is 4. So write the table of 4 here. After 0, 4. 4 2s are 8, 4 3s are 12, 4 4s are 16, 20, 24, 28, 32, 36 and 40. Highest number is 40. So you can write till 44. Now theater, 24 students are there. So draw a bar till 24. Then dance 40. Then vocal music 16. Then instrumental music 8 and one act play 4. So in this way you have to draw the third graph also. So in this way the remaining questions are homework for you. Now the sixth one is little bit different. In the sixth one, Yashwant gives different amount of time as shown below to different exercises he does during the week. Draw a bar graph to show the details of schedule using appropriate scale. Now, for running, he gives 35 minutes. For yogasan, 50 minutes. Cycling, 1 hour, 10 minutes. Mountaineering, 1.5 hour. And badminton, 45 minutes. Now, we observe here that somewhere it is minute and somewhere there are hours also. So, while drawing a graph, we should remember that unit should be same, means everywhere there should be minute or everywhere there should be hour. So first we will convert this hour into minutes. So 1 hour means how much? 60 minutes. So 1 hour 10 minutes means this will be 60 plus 10 means 70 minute. So cycling is 70 minutes. Actually, it is 1 hour 10 minutes, but 1 hour means 60 and 10, 70 minutes. Mountaineering, 1.5 hour. 1 hour is 60 and half hour means how much? 30 minutes. 60 ka aadha 30. So, 1.5 means 60 and 30. How much? 90 minutes. So, 35, 50, 70, 90, 45. So scale is not given in the question. So we can take here the scale as 10 minutes. Means 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. And if 35 minutes is there, then fifth line after 30, it will be 35. If 45 minutes is there, then fifth line after 40, this will be 45. And remaining numbers are all present on the y-axis. So in this way, you have to solve the practice set 19 on graph papers. Understood? Thank you.